In the previous video, we finished up our tour of the MotionBuilder interface, giving a brief overview of the interface and creating a custom layout. Now we'll look at the viewer in more detail, starting with the cameras and navigation controls. The viewer is the workspace in MotionBuilder where you can both view and interact with the objects in your scene. With the default editing layout, the viewer is in a horizontal format. If you wanted the viewer to take up the whole screen, you could switch to the preview layout or press Ctrl+Shift+3. Choosing the View Full Screen command or pressing Alt+Enter does the same thing, but without the controls around the viewer window. This viewing mode is ideal for seeing the details of your animation, but not so much for working in. You can exit full screen mode by pressing Alt+Enter again or the Escape key. For this video, we'll switch to a custom layout that we created, which gives us a large viewer with only a few other windows included. You can view your scene from different viewpoints by moving cameras around, as you would with a real camera. If you're new to 3D, you can ease into navigating by using the View Cube, which is a feature that's found in many Autodesk products. To display the View Cube, open the Preferences Editor from the Settings menu, click the View Cube section, and select Show the View Cube. You can also set up any preferences for the View Cube here, such as its position in the viewer. Click the different sides, edges, and corners of the View Cube to orbit around to different viewpoints. If an object is selected, the View Cube uses that as its point of interest. At any time, you can return to the original viewpoint by clicking Home. To hide the View Cube, you could use the Preferences Editor again, or just deselect it from the Display Head-Up Display menu. If you want to work with cameras and not just viewpoints like the View Cube, you can select one from the View menu. The default Producer Perspective camera makes objects appear to converge towards a central vanishing point. This makes objects closer to the camera appear larger than those that are farther away, similar to how our eyes see things. You can also view your scene from the producer orthographic cameras. These provide parallel projection views, meaning that an object's projection lines don't converge, like a 2D technical drawing. Because of this, the distance between an object and the camera has no influence on the size of the object, so two identical objects appear to be the same size, even if one's closer to the camera. You can switch among the producer cameras by choosing them from the View menu, but it's much faster to use their keyboard shortcuts. Press Ctrl+F to toggle between the front and back views. Press Ctrl+R to toggle between the right and left views. Press Ctrl+T to toggle between the top and bottom views. And to return to the perspective camera, press Ctrl+E. You can render your scene from any of the producer cameras, but they don't actually appear in the viewer as an object, so you can't directly manipulate or animate them. If you do want to have cameras that you can manipulate or animate, you need to create them by choosing View, Perspective, Create Camera. For example, with multiple cameras, you can animate the movement of each one and then switch between them using the Story tool. We'll cover how to do this in another video. Although it's not a real camera, the schematic view provides another way of displaying the objects in your scene, in this case as nodes in a hierarchy. You can also press Ctrl+W to switch to this view. Later on, you'll see how useful this is for selecting objects in large or detailed hierarchies, as you have with most character skeletons. In most cases, it's useful to work by viewing your scene through multiple cameras at once, which you can do by dividing up the viewer window. Select one of the viewer layouts from the View menu, or use these keyboard shortcuts to work more quickly. Press Ctrl+2 to split the viewer into two parts. Ctrl+3 to split into three parts, Ctrl+4 to split into four parts, and Ctrl+1 to return to a single view. But we'll go back to four views just to show you some other stuff. Only one view is active at a time and is highlighted by a white border. To change the camera that's used in that view, click in it so that it's active, then select a different camera. To frame an object in a view, select it and press F, which is the quickest way to get closer to the object you want to work on. In a multi-view layout, you can see that framing an object in one view does not frame it in the others. To do this, just place the cursor within the view's borders without clicking and press F. Press F again to toggle the view back to its previous angle. To frame all objects in a view, either press A or press F with nothing selected. And again, to frame all objects in another view, move the cursor within its borders and press A. The navigation buttons in the viewer toolbar let you move the camera around your scene in different ways. You can click and drag these buttons using the left or right mouse buttons to control the camera in different ways. One cool thing about MotionBuilder is that you can actually navigate with the camera while the animation is playing back in real time. With this multi-view setup, you'll notice that you can navigate only in the active view, which means that you'd have to click in each view first to activate it and then use the navigation buttons. Luckily, there's a faster way to work using keyboard shortcuts in combination with the left and right mouse buttons. Let's look at each tool. To use the orbit tool, press Ctrl plus Shift and left drag to revolve the camera around its interest, which is the object at which the camera always points. Right dragging orbits only the camera interest, which creates an effect similar to rotating a camera on its tripod. For the traveling tool, press the Shift key and left drag to track both the camera and its interest. And right drag to track the camera without its interest, which is a bit like orbiting. To use the dolly tool, press the Ctrl key and left drag to move the camera into or out of the scene without changing its field of view. Right dragging dollies both the camera and its interest. For the zoom tool, press the Z key and left drag to zoom in or out, altering the camera's field of view. The right mouse button doesn't do anything with this tool. You could also use the mouse's scroll wheel to zoom, but this zoom is incremented and is not as smooth as the zoom tool. To use the roll tool, press the R key and left drag to rotate the camera around its Z axis. While you probably won't roll the camera much while you're working, you may want to do this for special effects when you're rendering out your different camera shots. You can also right drag to roll the camera by 15 degree increments. The camera angle information is in the viewer's lower left corner, which is useful for getting the camera back to 0 degrees. One thing to note is that you can't orbit, dolly, or roll the orthographic cameras since they're projecting onto a specific plane. You can, however, pan and zoom with those cameras. If you want to undo any navigation change in the viewer, you can choose View, Undo Viewer Change, or press Alt plus Z. To redo that change, choose Redo Viewer Change, or press Alt plus Y. And to return to the camera's default view at any time, choose Default Camera View or press Alt plus Home. So now you should have a good idea about how to navigate around in the viewer with the default cameras. In the next video, we'll look at how you can control which objects are displayed in your scene, how those objects look, and how to customize which elements are displayed in the viewer window.